In today's video, we're going to go through that classic SPA trick of editing an object inline without the user ever having to leave the page. And what's really cool is we're going to do it by just adding about 4 lines of code. It's pretty awesome. Sick about. Right now, I have a little comments section below these posts, which doesn't use any JavaScript at all right now. And if you click edit, it will take you to like a new page and the user can change the post content. They'll go to like a view page and then they'll come back again to see what's just changed on that post. We're going to make it so that all gets changed in line. So if a user clicks edit, that little section here will just update and they can save without leaving this page. We're going to use Hotwire Dev to achieve this, specifically the Turbo Rails gem. So let's jump into that. Okay, we're going to start by adding the gem to our gem file and bundling. So I'm just going to run bundle add turbo rails. That's going to add it to the gem file and just run bundle for us. Awesome. Now that's done, we're going to run a little install script. I can't ever remember the name of it. Oh yeah, it's turbo install. Cool. So this is just going to set up all the JavaScript and stuff, edit all the files we need to get this working. Cool. Fantastic. Let's quickly have a look at what that changed. Okay. A couple of files are all in there. There's one other thing we do need to change. It's if we go to our application.js, the one which lives in app JavaScript and packs, because we're using Turbo, the new TurboLink stuff, it's actually worth just removing this stuff out of here, because in our actual application, there's a little helper handling the turbo stuff now, which includes all the new stuff. So make this editable in line, meaning the user doesn't ever leave the page to change it. We're going to wrap it in a magic tag. And what this tag is going to do, we're going to give it a unique ID. When we click edit, it's going to make a HTTP request to the page we're going to. It's going to look for a tag with the matching ID and replace the content within that tag. So click edit. This content here will just appear on this page. So nice and easy. We're going to use the turbo frame tag to achieve this. This is going to output the magic tag we want. So let's add this in. So right now we've got the comments being rendered here. So we just pass in a collection of objects and Rails does the magic. Actually this looks for this partial here for that. So it's a comment partial. Let's open that. So I'm gonna quickly wrap this in a turbo frame tag. Cool. That's nice. And let's see what that looks like. Okay, you can see we've got the little tag there, the element. They've both got the same ID though. That's bad. HTML doesn't like it when you have duplicate IDs. Let's try and post in the object we're working with. Okay, that's better. But that's not a very nice looking ID. Let's do DOM ID. That's nice. There we go, so it's now giving us the model name and the ID. Cool, okay, so now if we were to click this, let's see what that does. So we're gonna network quickly. Okay, we can see it's made a request, but nothing's changed. So this is because if we go to this new page, this form has not been wrapped in this tag yet. So let's quickly do that. So I'm gonna go to my edit page. Going to wrap the form in this. I need to update this reference here to be that variable there. Okay, so this is what it looks like right now. If I refresh the page, it's now got that turbo frame there. Cool. Okay, so let's see what this does. So we're going to click edit. It's made the request, it's updated the HTML on the page. I'm going to change the copy and click update, you can see it's posted the data to the regular controller as before, returned like a new show page, which just renders the same partial out, and it's updated it in line. That's fantastic. So I was a little bit skeptical of TurboFrame when I first saw it, but being able to change stuff in line like that is so powerful. Like, it's a really, really cool thing to be able to do, especially when you don't have to write any JavaScript to achieve it. That's really powerful. If there's anything else you want to see, please drop a comment in the comment box below. Remember to smash that like button because it helps other people find these videos. And thank you for watching. I really appreciate it, and I hope you enjoyed it.